evening, colleagues and brothers and sisters. I think I will start by saying that I would have wanted to read my notes, but when I look at the topic and after the previous speaker raising the idea of human rights in the continent, I think it's one area that we have to be very critical. Since October, it is the Africa Human and People's Rights Month. I want to just capture quickly what you have said. You said that, yes, it is true that the UN and Europeans, that notion of human rights was reserved for their own continent. But if you look at Africa, others will date back to 40 years ago, 1979. But others take it back to the 60s. And hence you find that the issue even around why we don't even know Africa Human Rights Day, it is the 21st of October, but we know the 10th of December as International Human Rights Day. And when you look even at the issues around instruments of elections, democracy, governance, and human rights, most of these African countries that we are even dealing with today have either signed, ratified, but not domesticated. You look at the SADC observer missions. Before any election or observers being deployed, at UNISA here last year, we had a privilege of having what we called a task team or a group of what they call SADC Advisory Council. They will come in, give you the briefing about what is the state of readiness. And they come to universities because that's where we have what we call a knowledge reservoir and engagement, because at UNISA for the past 10 years, we are lecturing and engaging with electoral management bodies from all 54 countries. They'll come for a month, commissioners will come for a week. But what is important on observation all the time is how you Europeans beat us with their numbers. Commonwealth, both in Mozambique, Botswana, they have their observers more than 3 months ahead, and they want to call analysts first, and they have field observers, which are your locals. And they stay, they don't see elections as a political process, they see it as an economic dividend. You move to Gaborone. Botswana has not ratified the African Charter on Elections Democracy. And I don't know how people tell it as a democratic stable country if they have not ratified the charter, which is almost since 2012, came into force in 2015. Botswana has not ratified that charter, even having signed it, it is worse. Mozambique just recently. Mozambique signed it in 2009 or 10, but only started to ratify, deposit it between now, 2018 and 2019. So it shows that member states, they are their own victims and perpetrators of human rights violations and even of election compliance. They don't sign all these documents. What is critical is that South Africa was the head of the observer mission in these two countries in 2014. 2019, who's heading these observer missions? Interestingly, it is Zimbabwe. And why Zimbabwe? Zimbabwe is the head of the observer mission. Now, Zimbabwe is the head of the observer mission, colleagues, what I can tell you, the SADC, all reports of SADC are always being challenged and questioned. Not only preliminary reports, but the final reports. What we are writing, and people who say, what I want to recommend is how do we influence electoral observer missions, is as the scholars, as educators, as thinkers, how do we change this narrative of our SADC election observation, including the African Union? Because it's not only SADC that is going to observe these two countries. It's going to be the AU, it's going to be the SADC, when I'm talking about the African front. Now, the European front, we have the Commonwealth. That is having resources. Mozambique, I can tell you, they are trying to have what you call electoral justice processes to say how they are going to deal with electoral disputes. Botswana, I don't want to raise it a lot because it is not a hot spot. It has never had a civil war. It has never had a coup. So it is a country that it is only exploding politically in terms of political divisions within the ruling party, defections, but observers normally don't entertain political factions. What they go for is their state of readiness in terms of political campaigns, access to media. They look even further on civil society participation in those elections. But like I said, the template of elections, again, it's still a Washington consensus. It is an American and a European context of how elections in Africa, other broadcasters from Voice of America, if some of you watch Shaka Zulu, you will use the word elections in Africa are selections, are not elections. Leaders select one another. So when Shaka Zulu goes on that topic, you know, and talk about observers, I remember when we went to Kenya in 2017, they said, who's observing the observers? Because observers in Kenya under the patron, I can tell you, the patron, Tabombeki, was so pushed and so angry with how do we conceptualize even the wedding when you say elections are free and fair. We went on a meeting as observers of EU, and his question, it was to question the mantra of free and fair election. And he says, but how do we justify it with this issue of Odinga coming up with a dossier saying elections were rigged on a computer? It was a server of Europe that has changed the numbers. So as observers, I can tell you, when you are a latecomer, you won't see the action. If you are an early bird in the observer mission, you know the violence that happens. You know the violations. And it is gone by the Commonwealth and the EU. And they shelved it. They don't share it with the EMB. They shelved it to nail us when they give their report. But SADC, AU, they are what you call electoral observers, tourists. You go to a place, you stay in their hotel, you don't go to Tete, you don't go to Cabo Delgado, you don't go to Chifefe, what some of you call it, Beira, Sofala province. And I think that's where the hottest of Mozambique is, that after Zagame has passed on, Mozambique is going to be facing elections on a different note of one Renamo founding leader has passed on a year ago. So Mozambique elections are interesting in that sense. The SADC electoral advisory council just recently saying everything is fine. But what David has painted now, it is different. It's because we're sending observers late, and we send tourists, and we send people who have interest in the minerals. And some of them are members of parliament who are part of observer missions, by the way. Finally, Botswana. Botswana, like I said, the SADC, it is there. It is the headquarters of SADC. So Botswana is safe automatically in terms of if any violence can erupt. You have all 14 member states we have who are in Gaborone. And Gaborone, like I said, it's a very small country. And these elections between the Khama and even masses, for the political observers, it will be the issue just to see the abuse of state resource. Who's having power over the state resource? Because during elections as observers, we can want to say what we want, but the ruling parties have got authority and power over resources, the media, the cars, the food parcels that they are moving around doing during election campaign, so they know how to master it. You know, so I can tell you that Botswana observers as well, they will cruise, they will even maybe go to Maun, they will go to Francistown, they will talk rather than observing elections. And I'm not critical because I've never been in the capital city for long. I've been put in the capital city for 2 or 3 days because we are the troublemakers in the meetings. So they throw you in a village. But in the village you meet with the real people and you get the real context of issues, that elections in Africa are not a panacea, are not a remedy. Elections are two things, finally, Mama. It's either it is conflict trigger and it's a power contestation in terms of representation. Yes, you need to be represented as you go for the ballot. But again, if you don't want representation, you can go through the bullet, which is a conflict zone. As I say, you must never think elections are a constitutional and a political process, but it's a power contestation of militarization, even of electoral management bodies. Frelimo has got 5 members who sits in that electoral commission. So you already have there. ZANU-PF did the same thing. You know, Malawi, SADC failed on Malawi. The Malawi report, why Malawi is still on an election dispute zone or election dispute virus or what you can call second of not even resolving the presidential dispute because there was a TPEX that was used on one of the election results. So how do you ask SADC come up with a report and say elections in Malawi were free and fair when you have an electoral dispute going on? Now I think Mozambique and Botswana, SADC will be tested again, but I can assure you SADC again and AU will still fail us as people who are watching it. And South Africa has got both vested interests in these two countries because both Mozambique and us, we went on the same year of 1994 of a new era. Botswana, there's nothing new, it's a change of political power that might go on. But for us, as South Africa, we have vested interest in Mozambique after the cyclone Idai. So elections, even they can be there. Environmental issues, as observers, we must be concerned about how to report about them. Because you cannot say people have voted, but people are still under their trees. There's no food. I think it is time of thinking.